to the book of Ezekiel, chapter 28. Ezekiel. And verse 12. Ezekiel, here it talks about Lucifer and how Lucifer became Satan. And we'll see what was the quality of Lucifer. Ezekiel 28, verse 12, it says, Son of man, take up a lamentation upon the king of Tyrus and say unto him, Thus say the Lord God, thou sealest up the sum full of wisdom and perfect in beauty. And verse 13, thou hast been in Eden, the garden of God. Every precious stone was thy covering. So here is saying that this person was in the garden of Eden. And saying, you are full of wisdom and perfect in beauty. So Lucifer was first, Satan was first a very beautiful creation. And also he was full of wisdom. And verse 17. Thine heart was lifted up because of thy beauty. Thou hast corrupted thy wisdom by reason of thy brightness. I will cast thee to the ground. I will lay thee before kings that they may behold thee. So he's saying, because of your beauty, you have corrupted your wisdom. So today we learn about corrupted wisdom. God gives us beautiful things in our life so that we can continue worshiping Him. God may give us beautiful face. Not everybody may have a beautiful face, but God may give you a beautiful face. Sometimes some people are filled with pimples. And you don't get one pimple on your face. Imagine for men, if they're having pimples, they cannot shave properly. Sometimes some people are blessed with beautiful hair. Their hair does not fall, whether it is borewell water or manjira water. And they are having very beautiful hair. Some people have beautiful body and they are healthy bodies. They look good. Some people have beautiful marriage partners. And they are blessed with beautiful marriage partners. Some people are blessed with beautiful houses, beautiful possessions, beautiful children. Some people are blessed with beautiful voices, beautiful sermons they can also preach. Some people have many things that are beautiful in their lives. Some people have less beautiful things. Some people have beautiful eyes, beautiful smile. And so we should not take pride in the things that are beautiful in our life, but we should worship God because it has come from Him. Lucifer, because of his beauty, his heart was lifted up and he corrupted his wisdom. Our beauty must be compared with the glory of God. Because whatever we have come, has come from God, is always short of the glory of God. And we must be thankful to what God has given us and not take pride that I am better than others. And so a person may be beautiful today, but if they are not continuing with God, they may lose their beauty. Just like today we know that Lucifer was beautiful, but today when he is portrayed in drawings, he is a very ugly creature and very terrible, horrible creature. And he has corrupted his beauty because he did not use his wisdom to preserve his beauty. And so same way, God gives us beautiful things, but if we do not use our wisdom, we will spoil the things that God has given us. Some people get good vehicles, but they use their vehicle very roughly and carelessly without maintaining it, and after 2-3 years, their vehicle is spoiled. They get beautiful houses, they have beautiful marriage functions, but after some time it is spoiled. Beauty and wisdom must go together. And they are admirable qualities. And so many times some people are very beautiful to look at, but when you talk to them, all foolishness comes from their mouth. And we say it is better they should have kept quiet. Because they just take pride in their beauty, but when they speak, there is no wisdom in their words. And some people are wise in the world, but not beautiful with the glory of God. And so God had blessed Lucifer with beauty and wisdom. And so he lost that wisdom. And so many times when we look within ourselves, we will lose the things that God has given us. Looking more at our beauty rather than looking at God will corrupt us. Lucifer is most of the time looking in the mirror about his beauty. How many of y'all like looking in the mirror? How many of y'all can dress up very quickly rather than taking 45 minutes to dress up? Some people will look at all directions in the mirror. Every part of their body must be beautiful. And then they come late to church. Because they were finding where their powder was. And some people take pride about themselves. They love posting images about their beauty on social media and WhatsApp groups and all. It is not wrong to post the pictures, but the motive of posting the picture is to take satisfaction about their photograph. They are showing to people that I am beautiful and appreciate me with a like and a thumbs up. And so many times believers have self-worship. Because they are focusing on their image rather than the image of Christ. And that's why Lucifer has lost his wisdom and corrupted it, because he is focusing on his beauty. So it is a serious matter with God how you handle the beautiful things in your life. You may say, what is wrong with all these things which I'm doing? But you are focusing on yourself. You're not focusing on God who has designed you. many beautiful people have corrupted their beauty because of worshipping themselves. They have taken pride in their beautiful things and themselves also. In their children, in their families, in their assets, they have taken pride about the beautiful things they have. How do you look at the beauty of God? Do you spend time looking at the beauty of God? And so whenever we are not comparing ourselves with the beauty of God, there is no shamefacedness in us. When we are always looking at God, we will not promote our beauty. Because we know that we are short of the perfect beauty. And so Lucifer is with God and still he is not looking at God. What made him corrupt his wisdom? And so many times believers, they are also functioning in that attitude where they were once wise and they were preaching great messages. Now they are preaching against the church. First they were teaching the church wisdom from the pulpit. Now they are criticizing the church because they have corrupted their wisdom. First they were preaching against the world system. Now they are loving the world system. What made Lucifer corrupt his wisdom even when he was with God? And what makes believers also corrupt their wisdom once they are in a good church, as Pastor Suresh said? And so believers are occupied with self-satisfaction. And so the more we are occupied with self-satisfaction, the more I will not be occupied with God. Once I love to serve God, now I do not like to serve Him one bit. And so now my wisdom tells me, get a big car for you. Don't be content in just serving God. You have to gain things of this world. And so whenever you are occupied with self-satisfaction, you are going to corrupt yourself. And so we, and not only just spoil ourselves, but we will spoil others. And this was the satanic disposition, that I must be promoted rather than God. And believers also, when they have self-satisfaction for themselves, they have the satanic disposition. And they minus God in their thinking process. And there is a silent desire for self-exaltation and applause from people. But true wisdom is humbling yourself even though you have got all the things that God has given you. God in His grace has given us when He knows that we don't deserve it. And as Pastor Suresh said, I have to have a thankful heart so that I can worship God. And so the underlying cause is to worship God through a thankful heart. Giving God the more value rather than giving myself the value. Lucifer is giving himself the value because he is beautiful. I am a good worship leader. I am a good preacher. My family is the best. My church is the best. My preaching is the best. And so we will take pride in the beautiful things that God has given us and give less value to God. And so let us be thoughtful about the beautiful things that God has given us, and let us have a humble heart and worship God. Have a desire to honor God for the beautiful things. True wisdom says, worship God for the things He has given you. But satanic disposition says, omit God's image in your life. Don't be satisfied with God's image, be satisfied with your image. And so let us focus on God, look at God, not look at ourselves a lot. Let us not be so much obsessed with the things and the beauty that God has given us. Let us take it as a serious matter that if I promote myself, I will corrupt myself. But if I lose myself for God, that is true wisdom. And that is the fear of God, that I will fear God and I will worship Him. And so let us come to that point that God's image is the most beautiful image, and whatever I have in my life is much short to the glory of God. Satanic disposition is to interpret my life by my image. But the Christ-like disposition, interpret your life by God. That is the true wisdom. And though He was given a full wisdom, yet He did not use that wisdom to honor God. We will get graduation, we will be in Bible college, and that all the wisdom God is giving you so that you can glorify God. So a wise person is a person who loves the beauty of God and wants the beauty of God for themselves. And does not take 1% pride and does not exalt and glorify their own beautiful image. Amen. Father, we thank You, we praise You, Lord, that You have given us beauty and wisdom. Help us not to take pride in it and lift our hearts in it. Help us to be humble and to be thankful for Your grace to give us these things. Help us to exalt in Your character and Your image so that we can preserve the things that You have given us. In Jesus' name, amen.